Katewa sub-county in the current Bunyangabu district was between the year 1981 to 68 a battlefield for the National Resistance Army guerrilla war fighters. The National Resistance Army fighters later transitioned into the Uganda People's Defense Forces after winning the battle that left scores dead in Katewa battlefield. The mass grave, which has a provision of opening and viewing the human skulls, also has an enclosure, a simple but permanent house structure around it. The skulls lay about 4 feet down in the mass grave where they were placed. A total of 400 skulls has been buried in the mass grave by John Munume, the Bunyangabu District Vice Chairperson, who is also the Katewa Sub-County Councillor. However, the skulls have reduced over time. Munume says that currently, only less than 50 human skulls are remaining inside the mass grave.
A few years ago, government came up with a plan to develop Katewa as a monument where we resumed the bodies of over 400 gallant fighters who died, who had been buried in the park, Rwenzori National. So we decided we bring the bodies together, such that the place is used as a monument. People, unknown people suspected to be witch doctors, normally come and break, take the skulls of our fallen comrades.
Manume says the monument will be useless once all the skulls are stolen.
Taking away the skulls of our fallen comrade is increasing. We ask for permanent security of the monument. Because it might be subversion. Some people may be in plan of taking away the monument such that people do not recall what happened.
People are buried here. They are part of those people who fought during that period from 1981 to 1986. Since then, the only achievement that we have seen is this tomb here. We want the government at least to develop this place to change it to another level.
John Bambali, the site caretaker, says unscrupulous people are taking advantage of the weak door locks to break through the monument and steal human skulls. He says his efforts to report the matter to various authorities have not yielded any fruit. According to Immaculate Irumba, the Bunyangabu District Tourism Officer, the development of Katewa Heroes Monument site is a top priority. She says the stealing of the human skulls is due to lack of proper management of the monument site.
Katewa, actually we call it Katewa Heroes Monument site. It is one of the sites we are looking at, working on, to see how we can develop it. The tourism sector has gone ahead to identify the local communities or the people staying around that site and formulate to bring them together under an association called Katewa Heroes Monument Association, Tourism Association. Our main aim is to develop the different attractions that we have around.
Irumba says that her office plans to zone and fence off the site as a way of securing it. Irumba says that once the efforts are intensified, even the stolen human skulls will be recovered.
Proper management of the site was not put in place. So our communities have a tendency of saying to whom it might belong, it's not really mine. So they don't take care of these community facilities that we have, even though the place has potential for tourism. It is like the witchcraft people who think that these skulls have medicinal importances, and those people who come to steal them. So if we put we put our emphasis on recovery, believe me, not we can recover this, because if you talked nicely to these people, they would even point to you who stole what. Then another thing is what we have there already, we need to protect now.
Katewa Sub-County, which lies on the slopes of Rwenzori Mountain Ranges, is one of the historical places that acted as a guerrilla hideout for the National Resistance Army from the 1981 to 1986 during the liberation struggle. Roger Sunday for the news.